Welcome to the Fiscal Incentives Review Board or FIRB website. All news, resources, and other information relevant to the FIRB and CREATE can be found here. Keep yourselves posted for updates by regularly visiting the FIRB website. The FIRB website houses the Fiscal Incentives Registration and Monitoring System or FIRMS. FIRMS is an online registration and incentives application portal for investors and enterprises. Here you will be able to decide on and monitor the enterprise applications. You may access FIRMS either through the right panel or through the FIRMS tab above. Once you click on either option, you will be directed to the FIRMS login and signup page. The FIRB has provided the IPAs their own FIRMS accounts for your convenience. Should you have any issues with your login credentials, immediately inform the FIRB Secretariat. We will be providing additional accounts with various access levels once available. After logging in, you will be directed to the home page of FIRMS. Once here, you should be able to see the Approvals tab on the left side of your screen. All the submitted applications can be found on this page. The IPAs will also be able to see the status of each application using this table. The IPAs will be notified through email whenever there are new submissions or updates on ongoing applications. Throughout the course of the whole evaluation, the applicant will also be notified through email about changes in status of their applications. To begin the evaluation process, there are a few steps that the IPAs need to do in order to ensure that the submissions are actually complete. If there are information fields that are missing or not filled out properly, or some documents that the applicant failed to upload, the IPA may tag the application as incomplete and provide detailed instructions to the applicant using dialog boxes within the system. The IPAs are required to acknowledge application submission within 3 days. If there are no deficiencies, the IPA may already tag the submission as complete. Note that only until the rectification of the information or completion of documentary requirements can the IPA officially tag the submission as complete and proceed with the evaluation of the application. Note that the applicants may monitor the status of their application via their firm's accounts. They will also be notified if there are any changes in status. Complete submissions will now be evaluated using the impact evaluation methodologies and frameworks set by the FIRB. The IPAs may choose to view the application docket in PDF on their browsers or download the Excel files for their computation. While the evaluation is not yet available in FIRMS, the FIRB has provided the IPAs with the manual CBA template that they can use, as well as the scorecard to guide the IPAs during their evaluation. If during the course of the evaluation the IPAs require additional documents for purposes of impact analysis, the IPAs may do so by specifying the request using that needs additional requirements button. This is a feedback loop that will only be concluded upon submission of complete requirements. If there is no need for additional requirements, the IPA representative may tag the submission as complete after they accomplish their evaluation. The recommendation on the application will now be submitted to the respective IPA boards for their decision. If the investment capital of the project is 1 billion pesos or below, the IPA board will be the one to approve or reject the project. The IPA representatives will reflect this in the firms by tagging the application as approved or denied. They will also be asked to upload the IPA resolution. If the investment capital of the project is above 1 billion pesos, the IPA board endorses the project to the FIRB by clicking Endorse to FIRB. This requires the IPA to upload two documents, one PDF file for the evaluation report and one Excel file for the supporting computations. Given the file specification limits, kindly compile in one PDF file all relevant documents and reports. The applicant will be able to monitor if the application is under IPA or FIRB evaluation by checking their dashboard. They will also be notified through email once the IPA or FIRB decides on the application. If the application is endorsed to FIRB, the FIRB will have to download the evaluation report as uploaded by the IPA. After taking up the application with the board proper, The FIRB Secretariat will upload the board resolution to notify the IPA of the decision. If the resolution reports that the application is denied, the IPA will reflect this in firms by clicking Deny. This prompts the IPA to upload the resolution. If the application is approved, the IPA representative will reflect this in firms by tagging the application as approved. This prompts the IPA to upload the IPA or FIRB resolution on the decision to approve. If the application is approved, either by the IPA or the FIRB, the terms and conditions will now be drafted by the IPA and discussed with the applicant. The firms has provided upload, download buttons and text boxes to facilitate the viewing and further discussion of contents of the terms and conditions. Aside from the terms and conditions, IPA representatives can request the upload of other registration documentary requirements via firms. Proof of payment for the applicable filing fees will also be requested from the applicant. After acceptance of the terms and conditions by the enterprise, the IPA should check if the terms and conditions and other documents are uploaded correctly. If there are missing documents, the IPA should click the Incomplete Submission button. If the terms and conditions and other documents are complete, the IPA may now click the Complete Submission button. The generation of the certificate of registration is currently done outside of firms. The IPAs will be the one to grant this certificate to the applicant. The IPAs at any point of the project lifetime and availment of incentives may monitor the project using firms. Should there be a need to withdraw, suspend, or cancel their incentives for whatever valid reason, the IPAs may do so manually. We are working to include these features in the system. We hope you find this video easy to follow and understand. For more information, we also prepared a more detailed instruction manual for you. You can find this on the FIRB website. For questions and suggestions, you may reach the FIRB Secretariat using the Contact Us feature in the website or through email at FIRBSecretariat@ntrc.gov.ph.